Simon & Schuster Audio presents Nothing Is Missing, a memoir of living boldly by Nicole Walters, read by the author.
Prologue. Everything is right, everything is wrong, nothing is missing. The paralysis caught me off guard. I felt a tingling above my right cheekbone and a heaviness on that side of my face. I'd woken up to the bright Los Angeles sunshine, but when I smiled at myself in the mirror, like I do every morning, I noticed that my eye wasn't turning up at the corner and that there was a wrinkle at my jawline. Was I aging suddenly? Was it an allergic reaction? I took an antihistamine just in case. I was in the habit of pushing off my health, and I didn't expect at 36 that I'd be sitting in a doctor's office asking why half my face was paralyzed and wondering if I'd be able to support my girls. If you don't already know me, I can pop a big back-of-the-teeth smile. It helps me connect with people right away. But it's also been an armor and a mask for me, something I can use to make me look way happier than I feel. But the paralysis stole my smile. When I look back at photos from that spring, I see what I was feeling. I couldn't hide it. That is so different from what so many of us do, which is just grin and bear it and make sure everything looks a certain way. Let's stop pretending like everything's okay. My smile is back, and with it, I can tell some truth, and I can hide a lot, but I don't want to hide anymore. If we're meeting in this book for the first time, I want us to live in truth. If you're returning, I want us to continue in truth. I'm Nicole Walters. I've built a business, Inherit Learning Company, a digital education firm that has afforded me many different things. It has afforded me a home, it's taken care of my kids, it's given me vacations and luxury, and more than anything, it's given me impact, visibility, and stability. And these are all things I lacked growing up. These are the things I thought that if I had them, that I'd made it. But what I found was that the business, the TV show that grew out of it, and all the chaos of my family life was distracting me from the deep inside work I needed to do. I was struck with anxiety. I was worried about the future. I was recovering from trauma from years and years of a crazy childhood and trauma that I was living day to day in my own home. My health scares, my burnout, they were symptoms of a bigger problem. At first, I leaned into what I already knew. You might have done this in your own life. When things start going a little haywire, you start seeing chaos on the horizon, you double down on what you know. I did more business. I booked more events. I gained more clients. I created content. I launched a TV show on a major network in the middle of a pandemic. And I served over 15,000 people in my consulting company. Business is something I understand. So I kept trying to do business. And much like you, because we're all a little like this a bit inside, I managed to keep it all together. I was changing lives. I was serving well as a consultant, a mother, a wife. But all the while, I was struggling to take care of myself. I was so worried about serving because it's precious to me to be able to show up for people, and not just the people in my family, my kids, but you too, that I served at the expense of myself. I love helping people find their purpose, and I love giving people the practical tools to make change happen. But I couldn't keep doing that good work if I didn't nurture myself first. I couldn't continue to ignore that my health and well-being mattered. And frankly, it's hard to put yourself second when your facial paralysis stares at you as a stark reminder of your choices first thing every morning. I'm writing this book because I've been through a lot, and I know you've been through a lot too. And we're all going to keep going through things because that's life. Hard things will arise and you'll have to deal with them. I've done a lot of things wrong, but I've also learned a lot. So when I see people suffering through things, I want to speak up. The majority of us just don't know that there are answers out there, and we think we have to figure it all out on our own. I spent most of my life figuring things out on my own. I did a lot of things the hard way, And I want to give you all the information I can because the more information you have, the more options you have. If you're anything like me, friend, when stuff like this happens, you can get really hung up on how you could have done everything better. I followed the steps. I did the plans. I bought the courses. I got the mentors. I went to therapy. I showed up in every way. I did every single thing I was supposed to. And everything was wrong. But after therapy, after leaning into God, if you've read this far, you've already noticed that sometimes I'm going to mention God. So I want to tell you that I'm a bootleg Christian. I'm the off-brand Walmart version of Lucky Charms kind of Christian. Can I tell my story effectively and not mention God? No, I can't. That would be denying something that is, I believe, true. And the only reason I would be denying it is out of fear of pushing people away because I don't want people to think I'm trying to push religion on them. But I also don't want it to be too sneaky, Jesus. This is just simply the language I speak, just like some people speak Japanese or Swahili. But don't worry, if that isn't the language you speak, you'll still understand these stories and what they've come to mean to me. If you speak woman trying to do it all, or motherhood, or daughterhood, or sprawling, unpredictable, messy life, you'll understand, because I speak them fluently. So, after the endless support of my family and friends, and after a whole lot of time recovering, I realize that the truth is that in this season, nothing is missing. Everything's very wrong, and everything is also very right, but nothing is missing. Nothing's missing because I've created the tools to support myself. Nothing is missing because long before I reached this point, I started learning hard lessons. Nothing is missing because I invested in the friendships and the family and the people to support me through these transitions. Sometimes the hardest part, friend, and I'm sure you can relate to this, isn't finding the tools. It's remembering to use them. We have to use the tools we've worked so hard to acquire. We have to use them because we are deserving. I'm deserving. You are deserving. I've lived the past 14 years of my adult entrepreneurial life feeling very alone in my pain, feeling like I couldn't quite share the completeness of what I was going through because it was mine and mine alone to carry. But as I've begun to live boldly and out loud, as I've begun to share my story, I've learned that if you walk in transparency, if you're willing to lean on the people around you, grief and gratitude and healing and happiness can coexist. I hope that putting my experiences out there makes it easier to believe that you can survive it all. Once you listen to this book, we will be on a path together. On this journey, we're going to encounter the stuff of life. There are so many things I've never shared because they were too hard or too raw. But when I decided to write this book, I knew I had to be honest to tell you the real story. Because the truth is, I wasn't born with wealth, confidence, or vision. I was born into poverty. And pretty early on, I realized that no one was coming to save me. When I learned that I was able to save myself, everything was different. And I want it to be different for you too. I want you to know that you're not taking this journey alone. I've been there. And all along the way, I'll be by your side. But I must tell you, you've got to be willing to get uncomfortable. And if you're not willing to get just a little bit uncomfortable so you can live a more comfortable, better life, well, close this book right now. Seriously. That's called having personal boundaries. At this point, if you've already bought the book, I'll give you the freedom to step away. However, I'll also remind you, you made an investment. You made a commitment. There was a moment, even if brief, that made you start this book and start listening. Trust that moment. A lot of people spend a lot of time waiting for that perfect mentor, life coach, tool, or resource to skyrocket them to wealth, happiness, and peace. All the while, they suffer as they stumble from one shiny object to the next until the day they realize that no one is coming to save them, and that they already have everything they need. That's when all hell breaks loose and they enter a new season. Sometimes people want to hold on to things that no longer serve them, but you have to let go so that your hands are free to grab whatever it is you're supposed to be chasing. And I say this as the person who likes to take all her Target bags up the stairs at once. I want to hold a lot. If there was a queen of baggage, call me Samsonite. But I'm learning that sometimes taking two or three trips is the better option. Why break your back in the process? Your new life is going to cost you your old one. When
we
leave our
parents. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.